गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सुरक्षा मैम हियर. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डू द चिवी पोएम फ्रॉम योर हनी कॉम बुक. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट मी टेल यू द मीनिंग ऑफ चिवी. चिविंग इज एन एंडलेस सप्लाई ऑफ डूज एंड डोंट्स. एल्डर्स यूजली डू दिस टू चिल्ड्रन. दिस रिजल्ट्स इन फनी सिचुएशंस. द पोएम गिव्स अ लिस्ट ऑफ कॉमनली गिवन इंस्ट्रक्शंस बाय ग्रोन अप्स, मीन्स एल्डर्स. सो when we are always told to do something or to not to do something, then it is called chivi. So first of all let have a look about the poet. Here is the poet of the poem Chivi. His name is Michael Wayne Rosen. He is born on May 7, 1946 at Harrow, London. Family: Harold, father; Connie Isaacsoy, mother; occupation: children's novelist and poet; nationality: British, means he belongs to Britain, United Kingdom. Next we see meaning of the word chivi. Giving pressure to someone to do the work in an annoying way, means when elders or when grown-ups gives us instructions and they always say do this, don't do this, do this, don't do this, this is called chivi. Now there are a lot of activities which the grown-ups always ask not to do to the little children. Okay, so we will start the poem reading from the book now. Now you can see chivi. Ask yourself as well as your partner, do you like to be always told what to do or not to do? Do grown-ups do this in your experience? Means are you always asked to do or not to do something at your home or at your school? Okay, so here is an interesting incident about this poet. When Michael was 5 years old, his mother took him to nearby school for admission. The teacher asked, what does your mother call you at home? Michael, don't, came the confident reply. Okay, when Michael was asked at the school, okay, what is your name, means what, by which name your mother calls you, then Michael very confidently answered, Michael, don't, because his mother used to say him, Michael, don't do this. That is why he answered that my name is Michael, don't. Okay, so here is a note for you. To chivi is to nag, to continuously urge someone to do something, often in an annoying way, according to the dictionary. Now read the poem. Grown-ups say things like, speak up, don't talk with your mouth full, don't stare, don't point, don't pick your nose, sit up, say please, less noise, shut the door behind you, don't drag your feet, haven't you got a hanky, take your hands out of your pockets. So these are the things that the grown-ups, means elders, always do with little children. Okay, here I describe the poem. That grown-ups, means elders, say speak up, means they ask you to speak, to tell something. Don't talk with your mouth full, means when your mouth is full with the food or with something else, you haven't to talk, you needn't to talk. Don't stare, means you haven't to look very seriously. Don't point, sometimes you point at things with your fingers and they always say you, don't do this, this is not a good manner. Don't pick your nose, even when you make expressions with your nose, then they say don't pick your nose. Sit up, sometimes this is they order to sit. Sometimes they ask to say please, sometimes they ask to make less noise because you are always shouting. Okay, now sometimes they give the instruction of shutting the door behind you. When you always open the door, you let it open. Don't drag your feet. Sometimes you walk dragging your feet, pulling your feet, and it creates a bad noise. So it is also not considered as a good manner. Haven't you got a hanky? Sometimes you can say that clean your nose without hanky, and they ask you to have a hanky and not to clean your nose with some else cloth. Take your hands out of your pocket. Sometimes you stand with your hands in your pockets, and they say that this is not a good manner. You have to sit straight, not to stand like this. okay. Next, pull your socks up. Sometimes your socks are rolled up. Okay, then they say, okay, pull up your socks. Stand up straight. Even sometimes they say that you have to stand straightly, not to bend. Okay, say thank you. Sometimes you don't thank a person or a neighbor or even your grandparents. Then they instruct that you have to say thank you. Don't interrupt. Interrupt means to disturb. Means you haven't to disturb them when they are working some important. No one thinks you are funny. Sometimes they also say that you haven't to make your mood unhappy because nobody will like you. They will say that this boy or this girl is not funny, is not a happy child. No one thinks you are funny. This means take your elbows off the table. Sometimes you are sitting on the dining table and you are not showing good manners. You are sitting with your elbows down on the table. So they always instruct you to take away the elbows from the dining table. Can't you make your own mind up about anything? And sometimes when you irritate them by asking so many things, then they say, can't you be independent? Can't you decide yourself? Kya karna hai, kya nahi? So this was about the poem Chivi. So you can see this was the poet and this was the meaning of Chivi. Now these are the things that they have described. See how to sit, how to do this, how not to do this. Okay. And here about door open, pockets out, pockets in, right? And and even taking hanky, using hanky, handkerchief. Okay. Now, pull up your socks up to stand straightly, and even about sitting on the dining table without pulling your elbows on the dining table. And you have to use the words say please and say thank you as well. Okay. And even when you are confused, when you cannot decide, they always say you too that can't you make up your mind? Means can't you be independent? Can't you decide something yourself? Summary of the poem. It is again what I have told you, and I will read it again for you. When the poet was 5 years old, his mother sent him to the nearby school for his early education. As we all are familiar with the strict teachers of the primary schools as well as their rules in the class, both the things are evil for the cute children of the school. But what can they do to save themselves from school? They have to suffer. Something was happened to the poet also. Teachers annoyed him by many ways. So read this poem by taking yourself in place of poet. Just guess, just imagine that you are in the place of poet, and then read this poem and you will enjoy this poem. These were the words, hard words you can say. Drag means to pull or to pass slowly. Interrupt means to stop by breaking or to obstruct or to disturb. Stare, to look fixedly. Ghoor kar dekhna. Okay. So this was your poem, Chivi. I hope you might have enjoyed it. It's a little poem. Also do the question answers and read this poem and enjoy this poem. Thank you.